It's very, very difficult for a young person to be growing up in Newham because it is a war zone. Look at the amount of young people who have lost their lives. It would be wrong for us not to call it a war zone. You know, that would just simply denying the problem and putting a plaster over a big stab wound. It's not going to fix it. You need surgery, it really does. And this is what we're doing. We're doing specific surgery to a very, very big wound that needs to be fixed. When they look at me, they see stereotype. When they look at you, they see stereotype. That's something that we can't shake off. But what we can do is change their hearts and minds through what we say and what we do. You know, and that's the only thing we can do, prove them wrong with our success. Nothing's going to stop you from achieving it, only yourself and the time that you put in.
Raheel, he changed my life completely. Like, from being on the roads and doing dumb things, I realised it's not even worth it like that. Not only he taught me, he basically break it down in a couple of details, like, all the people that you hang around with, they're not your boys. And I already seen it. So he changed big time. And I come a long way. Like, I come a long way.
You start off at the bottom and you work your way up. You learn the bottom, you learn how to do it the basic way. Everything else just kind of falls into place.
I have lost friends. There's people losing their lives. And there's vulnerable people getting caught up on the wrong side. I all feel safe walking around Newham. I only feel safe at the gym and the compound, to be honest.
I want to see the mayor of Newham, yeah. I want her to come down, because they're spending mad peas on other buildings, but they never think about us. For him to think about it, and he's not even the council, he's wasting his own money to open a gym for us. At least what they can do is just return him from honor. Man, come on, man.
When they say it's going to trickle down, it ain't trickling, nothing's trickling down. The only thing that's trickling down is blood down people's bodies, and that's it. The only thing that we see trickling down is blood. And that ends up on the community. There ain't nothing but that. Nothing is trickling down. Why would you want to have a police officer outside the school? Why? Why? Do you have that outside those rich schools? Affluent areas. This is where I found an actual sawn-off shotgun.
How old were you?
I was no more than about, I'd say about 9 years old. And it was just over here, wrapped up in the bag. Being a kid, I started trying to put stones in it and thinking that it would work. I was a kid at the time. I broke the shotgun. Look around, like 360, all you're seeing is social deprivation, tower blocks and tower blocks. You've got a small opening over there with you can see a bit of sky, but the rest of it is just tower block, you know? And this is where my youth was when I was growing up. You don't see kids playing out in this area, and there's a very, very important reason why. The issue with alcohol, the issue with gambling, the issue with knife crime, when you start seeing these problems in the community, and you're asking yourself as a parent, why would you allow your child to be out in an environment that's just so hostile and so dangerous? And it's just rife. Would you let your child grow up or play out in this area? I know where I'm from, I know where I came from, I know what it means to have skin colour. I'm really proud to have the values that I have. And those values didn't come easy. They come at a cost, and I had to lose my freedom and be put in prison for me to change my life and to make that conscious decision. I just hope that people can make that conscious decision before they commit a crime and before they go to prison and before they do these things. Won't be long before we're ready. You help promote this team?
Of course I will.
Come on, my bro.
Well, the community, innit?
So. Come on.
It's a different world we're living in to the one I work in. There was nowhere for the youths them to go. The youth clubs have all shut down. We need something like this to for the kids them to see and that there is someone there for them, that truly is there for them. Yeah. I lost my son a few years back. Knife crime, stabbed to death. Yeah. Maybe if this was open when my son was here, probably wouldn't be in the position he was in.
There's a massive responsibility to make sure that he, she doesn't pick up one of these again. And that in the wrong hands can do so much damage. Just takes one poke from this in the wrong place and that's it. Right now, a lot of these young people are acting in vengeance. A retaliation is a must. And that's something, that's the word on the street. Retaliation's a must, and it's not a joke. You could turn a corner, Newham is very notorious for that, where you could turn a corner and all your enemies happen to be there. And they're all brandishing weapons. They're called rideouts, where your enemies go look for you. So young people don't want to be caught. It's called slipping, caught lacking. They don't want to be caught off guard. And young people see this as a form of protection. And also to gain status, to earn ratings, it's not the way about it. Literally, this will end, take you two places, either in prison or in the ground.
Thank you so, so much.
Thank you, bruv, you're doing constructive stuff.
I start to not know even look like it.
Apache.
It's just got to the stage where everyone's become desensitized. It's normality, and to me, death, trauma, and death for murder, it shouldn't be normality. That should be frightening.
Boris Johnson, Sadiq Khan, Home Office, Met Police, Cressida Dick, Customs. Do you think when you've got things like this that could be legally bought, and all you gotta do is be 18 and provide no documentation of a purpose of why you need this, that we're not gonna have the problems we're having with knife crime? Hey, listen.
How are these out here? Like, how is a retailer making these get into the community? You can't tell me that one of these knives haven't killed a person and these retailers are aware that that's happened. Do you know what I'm saying? And to be able to sell that to the community, I'm just thinking like, it's real cold-hearted, man.
Do you know the bigger picture? The bigger picture is this, that if you were to start your own knife manufacturing outlet, call it a hunting or survival store, and you were to sell those weapons, you would be called a gang.
Yeah, 100%.
If I done it, I would be called a terrorist.
100%.
If a white person does it, it's called a business.
Where?
Yeah, it's facts though.
Yeah, that'd be just... that's him, yeah. Follow that. I said the rest of
it,
yeah.
Make it frame.
Oh, he's an adjunct, bro, yeah?
Yes, same as
my phone. Alright, no, fuck him up, bro. Great.
Start making bread out here, my guy. Come on, the right way.
Seriously, whiskey, love for that. Come on.
No problem, brother.
construction jobs, they earn big, they earn real good money. And when you learn the trading, you learn the skills and you've got the CSCS card, bruv, you can step aside and start making your own people. Do you know what I'm saying? Taking on jobs yourself. When you've got your purpose and you've got your goal, you don't have to look back. And then you'll see people come to you and ask you how you done it so they can go off and do their same thing. Do you know what I'm saying? It's crazy how the world changes when you're on the path of success. And when you start becoming successful and you start working towards something positive, the world changes and you look at the world differently. Not long, bro, you'll be up. Right, so that's out of the way.